Hello, today we're going to go over a new ability in the SIGNL4 program to send and receive emergency alerts. Emergency alerts can be used to send blast messages to your entire team, whether they're on duty or off duty. Your team's going to receive these messages. If you want to make sure everybody receives an alert for any reason, such as weather warnings for a tornado or an active shooter at a location, or even something like one of your users has broke down on the side of the road and he wants to send an alert to the team so somebody can come and help him get up and running again. The emergency alert also ignores the signaling options on your phone. You'll see here for user Robert, he's set to push instantly, text after 5 minutes, and call after 10 minutes. However, when I send out an emergency alert, he's going to get all three of those right off the bat to make sure that the users know the alert is out there. So they're going to receive the alert in as many ways as possible to try to get the alert answered and serviced. So if I go back to my main screen here, and if I scroll down to the bottom and select the new emergency signal option on the right, and let's just type in emergency, and now I'm going to hold to send this alert. And we're going to see this alert come through. There is the push notification and the text message, and now here is my phone call.
There is a new sign for your team superheroes for the service or system healthcare with the subject emergency for Robert.
In addition, once I go in and look at the alert actually has to be confirmed by all members of a team, whether they're on duty, off duty, or logged out, to make sure that everybody receives and confirms this alert, so that we know that they have it and have acknowledged it. So in this case, I can go ahead and acknowledge the alert on both of my two users here, but my other three users need to also confirm the alert before the alert can be closed. We can also send an emergency alert from the web portal. Here in the web portal, to send an emergency alert, if you just click on the signals page and then click on the new signal button. Once on this page, you see the emergency signal option and a switch to turn that on. When we turn that switch on, the members that receive the alert goes from only one team member on duty to all team members. And from there, you put on your subject and the text of the alert, and then click on the send button, and a new alert goes out to the team. In addition, inside the web portal, if I go to the signals page again, you'll see them. Your alerts are listed here. And I have the emergency alert, both the one sent from the mobile app and from the web page listed. So if I click on one of the options, it'll show me the alert and then who has already acknowledged the alert and let me know that these people have received and acknowledged and the other users are currently waiting. So you'll see that we have our other users here have all received it and we're just waiting on them to acknowledge the alert. Now the settings for these emergency alerts override the settings for the team. You'll notice that I only have to have one person confirm an alert set for my SIGNL4 settings. However, the alerts inside the app are requiring every user to have those set. In addition to that, my user settings for Robert for my signaling is set to a push instantly and then a text and then a phone call if I still haven't answered. However, the emergency alert pushes to the push notification, the text message, and the call all immediately to make sure that the user receives this emergency alert in any way possible to make sure that they have the information for safety reasons.